This week on the Extreme Bass Angler, Strike King Rage Swimmer smashes shoreline smallmouth.
Oh boy. Oh God. Wow.
The September Bass Blues on topwater.
Oh boy. Hey. Okay. The size of that thing.
And it's pigskin jigs for hogs.
Oh boy. Look at him. Whoa, whoa.
The Extreme Bass Angler is presented by Goldfish in Ontario, Strike King Lure Company, St. Croix Rods.
Oh, look at that. Wow, wow, wow. 59 degrees. Hey, welcome back. What am I gonna do this afternoon? Came out 2 o'clock in the afternoon and I decided, you know what, I'm gonna go out to one of these small lakes up here in Algoma, up here on a little road trip. I'm gonna catch some bass. I get out here and it's like 45, 50K gusts, winds and stuff. And you say, is it safe to go? If it's safe to go, I'm gonna go. You know, it's called Extreme Angler. You just gotta play safe. But how am I gonna fish? Power fish, you know me. Rage Swimmer. And I'm gonna rig it on a little different head, a little jig head with a big thick gauge hook with a little blade on the bottom. So it's almost like the best of both worlds. Soft plastic, with a little spinnerbait or blade, just something to get those fish attention. Where am I gonna fish? I'm gonna use this stuff you see around me, this wind, to my advantage. I'm gonna go right in tight, put the power poles down when I have to, trolling motor on a high, and just keep zigzagging back and forth from 4 feet to 6 to 8, and just pounding the shoreline like I was maybe in early season. Pound the shoreline, because those big fish, that's where they go right now. They're all through the water column this time of year. But in late October, there's always going to be some fish when the temperatures are in those mid-50s to maybe 60 degrees. But it's the 50s are the key for me. 50 plus is the key because those fish are still biting. They'll still chase horizontal baits and you will catch them. But I'm going to show you how that Rage Swimmer today, this afternoon, is going to catch us some bass and inspire you to go to the store, find them, buy them, fish them, and get hooked, just like I am. Okay, I'm gonna power fish like I said I would with a 6'8 St. Croix, medium heavy, Legend Extreme casting rod, 16 pound gamma fluorocarbon, and that little Rage Swimmer, I got it rigged on that little jig head I showed you with the little blade and the heavy gauge hook. Like again, I'm gonna be fishing that shallow stuff, casting right into those rocks, maybe the edge of weed, different things where I know those fish are just cruising, mean, ugly things looking for stuff to eat. When they see that kick and tail of the Rage Swimmer with the rib body, bigger profile, it's gonna make those bigger fish see it and inspire them to bite. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, dude. Big fish too. Oh God. That Rage Swimmer, huh? Look at that. Look at that bait. Think they want to eat that bait? Whoo, lordy. Look at that. Oh, God. Hey, wow. Wow. Rage Swimmer, dudes. Hold on, hold on. Don't want to get my hand, do you? You don't want to get my hand, do you? Look where that bait is, too. I got to show you this. Look at it. Look where the bait is. You think he wanted it? Think these things work? I'd say, whoo, lordy. Oh, look where the hook is too. Look where you got that right there. See that hook? Barely in the skin. Look at that. You talk about sharp hooks. That's why I rigged that with that little jig head that I showed you. Right there. Little Rage Swimmer, man. Look at that. Beautiful bass, boy. 4+ maybe. Autumn is a time of plenty. Whatever bait you want to use, but something about that little kicking tail of that little swimming bait entices them. I'll put them in there and take some pictures. Put them in here. Oh, fish. Beautiful bass, man. Beautiful bass. That's the color of bait. Seriously. The green pumpkin with the pearl belly. Psychotic. I used a little KBD Swim and Shiner in the exact same color tone. This color combination is fantastic when you're feeding on perch, crayfish. It doesn't matter. It's the contrast. The pearl with the green pumpkin and the black, it's just killer. Other options. You got a little goldish finish like that. But again, the pearl belly, green pumpkin. You can go to the bright snow white with a crystal back like ice. Again, it's all about letting the fish see it right now this time of year and working the bait slow. The little tail kicks with the little blade, as long as you have something that resembles something that they look like they eat and they can see it in the water, they'll eat it. Two size heads, quarter ounce and a bright chartreuse if I'm gonna fish the deeper edges, 1/8 ounce if I'm gonna fish the real shallow stuff, 2 feet to about 6 feet of water, which is perfect. With the angled head like that, deflects off a rock and any kind of wood, I can just retrieve it nice and slow. They both feature the big, thick gauge hook, very sharp. When a fish grabs it, you catch them. Oh yeah, smallmouth bass. Oh boy, look at that thing, hey? He saw that one, he had to eat that one. Oh man, just gorging on the shoreline. Got a big fish, a medium fish, and a smaller fish. Now I know you might say to yourself, is that a smaller fish? Well, as long as he ate that right swimmer, I'm happy. But this is a time of giants, so we're gonna let him go and look for his great big mama. Ready? Go on, get. All right, let me tell you exactly what we're doing. Waves blowing in here, and I'm fishing in here when I get the areas that I need that look really good with rock, and I see stuff in the water with my glasses, I put the poles down and cast to it. But I don't have to. I'm just drifting with the wind that Mother Nature just pushed me along, casting shorelines. And I can go to the calm side. You say that calm side's easier to fish? Maybe it is, but the fish are here. And the rage swimmer with that little paddle tail kicking, the rib body, and that little blade at the bottom, it's just killer. They see it, they're eating it. This is about power fishing for shallow fish in fall in shallow water.
Strike King Rage Swimmer features a thick rib body and oversized paddle tail. The versatility and balance make this bait a must-have in every rod locker. Available in 10 colors and 2 sizes. Retails for $529 US. Visit strikeking.com.
Right there. Come on, big fish. Where are you, boy? Where are you? Man, oh man, do I love that little rage swimmer. Killer, killer little bait. It finds him, provokes him, makes him bite, and catches him big. You see him? You better buy some real fast. There he is. Oh God. Wow. Wow. Rage swimmer. Look at it. When they want to eat it, they destroy it. Look. You can't even see the bait in the fish's mouth, man. You can't even see the bait. Well, you can see the hook sticking out of his jaw. He ain't a big giant bass, but man, oh man, what excitement. What a little football too, look at him. Look where he's got it. Look at that. Right through the side, man. You ask me why I use those big, thick gauge hooks? That's why. Why I use the heavy rods? That's why. Because I want to catch him hot and heavy right there. He's just a football. We're gonna let him go. Okay? Look at him. Look at the shape of that fish, man. He's a real football. But he won that rage swimmer. Let's let him go right here. Ready? Ready? Go on. Okay, tools of the trade, man. The 6'8 St. Croix, medium heavy, 16 pound gamma. And I got it with that 4-inch rage swimmer. But this one I got on the casting rod. But another option for you guys, I love to throw the spinning rods. I'll use a braided line, 15 pound gamma torque on a 7-1 Legend Tournament Bass plastics rod made just for this kind of stuff. But it's got the power and sensitivity that you need. Sensitivity to feel those spongy bites because the bass are eating it like that. But it's got the power to set, and with the braid, there's no stretch. So when those smallmouth decide to eat the rage swimmer, you're gonna catch them. Oh boy. Oh God. Wow. Wow. Just sick, man. Sick. Look at that. When they eat those baits, do they want that rage swimmer right there? Do they? Look at that, man. Oh God. Come here, boy. Another big, thick, beautiful fall bass on that big bait. Look at it. And he's in the net. Oh Lordy. And I think that's going to conclude my afternoon of bass fishing in late October, catching beautiful big smallies. Look where he's got that too. Look at that. Look where that bait is too. I got to show you that, man. Look where that bait is. Do they eat this thing or what? Wow, do they eat it. Look at him. Talk about a gorgeous smallmouth bass. He's a warrior. See those marks on him and stuff? That's character. You know why? You're big and beautiful, and I love you. I could take some pictures of you, but you saw that rage swimmer, you had to eat it. We'll put him in a box, take some photos, and let him go. Wow. Oh, Lord. And that concludes our day of broadcasting right here in fall for big, fat, smallmouth bass with the rage swimmer. You see it, buy it, catch it, get hooked. You believe me now? The rage swimmer smallmouth in October. Look at the size of them beasts. Just gorgeous. Catch them, kiss them, and let them go. Ready you? Go on. Look at this thing. Look at the belly on that. And there she goes. Bye.
Closed captioning of this program presented by Sportsman Protein Shake. The Extreme Edge. Presented by Strike King.
What do you do when it's early September and you go to your favorite lake and the guys are telling you that the topwater bite is on fire? Do you go there anticipating that you're going to catch all kinds of big fat fish and stuff and have your big poppers like the Spittin' King, the big cavity splash, because you go to lakes that potentially have some really big smallmouth and all of a sudden it just goes, whoa, crash landing. Do you put the boat back on the trailer? Do you complain to your friends that wasn't happening? Here's an option to help you catch more fish on top in those September dog days. What I'll do, I'll go with the KVD splash, a real subtle little walking little bait, but I'll even tone it down to the small one. I call it the baby splash, and it's got that little concave mouth, the small hooks, the little tail feathers. There's opportunities to catch all kinds of fish and all kinds of topwater, but sometimes the conditions are perfect. It's calm, you know, the water temperature is perfect. You know the fish are gonna eat on top and they're not eating it. Vary your approach, change to a smaller bait and fish those same areas with different cadence, fast, slow, slow, pop, you name it. I guarantee you those slight little changes will make a big difference between not catching and catching. So let me show you a couple techniques that I use that you can use in September during those dog days when those fish are suspended over deep water. Look at that there, all those suspended fish. 8:45 in the morning, suspended fish, there's bait there. They're up high, they're all through the water column here. We're sitting in 21.5 feet of water and the fish are like 10 feet down, 9 feet down, look at them. Those are like predators. Those are those smallmouth that you think, oh, where are they? I know there's smallmouth in the lake. When they suspend like that and they're feeding on smelts or young of the year perch or whatever it is, that's some fresh hatch of minnows, whatever bait fish they're eating, they can be tough to catch, but you can still catch them if you apply yourself, topwater, drop shot, and everything and anything in between. That little KVD splash, all you gotta do is just work it slow. Slow, it'll do everything else you need to do. Because sometimes those fish, yeah, they'll come up and they'll blast it and they'll get all excited and, you know, maybe there's other fish around, so you get that seagull factor, I call. But sometimes you just have to put it out, let it sit, take your time, and work it with small little pops. Small pop and sit. Because we all love it when you work it fast and the fish are really aggressive and they just smash it and stuff. But I don't know, man, you know, sometimes they can be so stubborn. You see them on the sonar, you see the hooks, you know they're there. And you know you're gonna catch them on top because you've done it before. Your buddies are telling you that these lakes are fantastic for topwater bite, but you can't get them. Those little changes, like putting the small bait on, small pops, will help you catch more fish when those fish are still wanna eat and they're still on top, but they just have to be tricked. Right there in September, there's one. Oh boy, hey, what a size of that thing. On a small KVD splash, early in the morning, You just got to take your time, fight them out, keep them out of the weed. I got weed in front of me there. I got that small little treble hooks. So you just got to hope that he's got it good. Fat little piggy. Let's just hope he's got it good. Just take your time. Here he comes up again. Here he comes up. Oh, it's a fat one. Put that net right there. This is when it's crucial here, when they're close. You don't want to stretch it. Which side are you coming on, boy? This side? Okay, come on this side. He just got in the corner of his mouth. Oh, boy. Just the sheer weight of these fish. It's incredible. Here he comes. Beautiful fish. See if I can put him into the net. Well, this is when you don't want to rush it. Just let him pull a bit. Let him pull. This is crucial. I use the braid so I can get longer casts with the smaller baits, but you don't have any stretch, so you got to make sure you got that right rod. And, oh, that's what you use that frable net for right there. Boy, did he eat that too. He ate it like it's real. Look at that. First thing in the morning, a little topwater splash. And sometimes it's all about the size of the bait. These fish are feeding on these little, small, little crustaceans, whatever, minnows like this. And I'm using that bigger splash, and I'm seeing fish rolling on it, not even eating it, just rolling and stuff. So you gotta change that splash. You think sometimes, no, I got one tight on, it's fine. The bigger one, they're aggressive, they're gonna eat it, but they don't. Listen to what the fish want. Look at the minnows, see the bait fish. You know, match the hatch. The fly fishermen have it right to a T, and us bass fishermen, we have to adapt the same way. You know, change the size of our baits, colors of the bait, presentation speeds, match whatever the fish want, and you'll catch them too. When life gives you lemons, you make lemonade. And when you want to catch them still on top in those dog days of September, consider the Strike King KVD Splash. Little baby bait catches big brown bass. Da, 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 da. You know what today is? It's football day. Football finesse in early October here in Ontario. What I'm talking about is right here. The Strike King football finesse with the little junior KVD chunk. And we're going to chase smallmouth bass with my favorite St. Croix 16-pound fluorocarbon. We're going to power fish on shallow rocks, points, maybe some weeds, but I'm going to look for areas that maybe with this wind that those fish are pushing up, the bait fish, maybe the crayfish, I don't care what they're eating, but I'll put that little bait in the same places those fish are corralling the bait fish, and hopefully we'll score some touchdowns with the Strike King football finesse in fall in Ontario. This is about short range, close range, full contact, hand-to-hand combat. Seriously, little football finesse, 3-ounce. And I'll tell you why, it's got that little football head. See how it's horizontal more than vertical? So I can just slide it over little pebble rocks or anything that's, you know, intrusive on the bottom and stuff. But it's just another jig, another option to fish when you want to have some fun, variety. You know, that's when you go to a restaurant, you see a menu and you say, well, it's about variety, difference. You know what I mean? Fish want to see something different too. So I just marry it up with a little junior KVD chunk. At that time, yeah, I felt you, bugger, eh? I felt you eat it. Boy, when you feel those bites, look out, because it's lights out catching fish. Look how nice they pull too. Wow. Look at that, just a beautiful looking fish. Beautiful. Look what he's got in the side of his jaw. Look what he's got in the side of his jaw. You know what that is? My football finesse. Look at him. That's a little touchdown right there, boys. We're gonna let him go right here. Ready, fish? Let you go right here. Ready? Ready? Go on. Sitting in about 11, 12, pitching up to about 3, 4, bringing it down 5, 7, 9. That's the slope where they're sitting on, all through there. They just keep coming in and feeding on the bait. That little wind coming in like that helps big time. Because you know they're not just sitting there, they're moving around. They're chasing, they're eating. This is a time of year of eating, man. Just sitting in time for them to just sit,
They're chasing food. That time. Oh boy. Look at him. Whoa, whoa. You think he wanted to eat it? Hey? You think he wanted that dual jig? Wow. Look at it right there. Beautiful big fish right here. Look at that. On that football finesse. You saw it, you asked for it, so I have delivered. The Strike King football finesse in fall. Dudes, that is a killer technique. You gotta definitely use it, man. You know, you say finesse, but finesse, you think sometimes, you know, lighter rods, spinning rods, and different kind of stuff. Look how he's got that right there. Did he want that little football bait? I'd say he did. Look at that thing. That's a way to start my afternoon here in the Muskokas again, catching smallmouth bass with my mom. One of my most favorite ways to fish, heavy gear with what they call finesse, but boy, oh boy, it's not finesse. It's power fishing for fish like this. Oh yeah. Come on, you earned your release. Big, beautiful bass. Ready? Go on. You give me a shower. But you know what? It's just another technique when you want to get out and catch some fish with casting gear and make those smallmouth just fight to their full potential. Consider the Strike King football finesse up here for smallmouth bass in Ontario in October. It's waiting for you.
The Extreme Bass Angler has been presented by Young Steel's Ford Lincoln, Gamma Fishing Lines, Rage Tail Soft Baits, Interstate Batteries, Top Gun Marine. Visit us at fishextreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.